this.
What is the most offensive joke that you've ever written?
If only Africa had more mosquito nets, then every year we could save millions of mosquitoes from dying needlessly of AIDS.
Wow.
It's a beautiful joke.
I told this joke. Made sure the old people couldn't hear. Like that. I went, okay. Father, sitting at home, just reading the newspaper. This little girl comes running in. She's only six. Hello, darling. Hello, daddy. You've been playing? Yeah. In the park? Yeah. With your friends? Well, until the man came along. Till the man came along? Yeah, a man came along and he asked my friends to leave, so it was just me and him. Darling, come over. Whatever happened, none of it was your fault, okay, darling? None of it was your fault, but tell daddy every detail. What happened? He took me behind a tree so no one could see what we were doing. Oh, God, darling, and then what happened? He took my dress off. Oh, God, what happened next? What happened? He took his thing out. Oh, God, darling, and then what happened? Nothing, that was it. Oh, well, make something up.
Like, I'll never forget the first time I ever got a bad report card in school. First time I got a bad report card in school, I brought it home, I gave it to my dad, and my dad beat me. Beat the hell out of me. But I learned something. Because the next time I got a bad report card in school, I brought it home, and I gave it to my mom. Let her take the hit. I don't own a gun. I'm against guns, to be honest. When I was a kid, my parents had a gun. My parents said we had to have a gun. Gotta have a gun to protect the five children. Gotta have a gun to protect our five children. Of course, they eventually got rid of it to protect their four children. I'm not gonna lie, it was fun while it lasted. I was getting pretty good towards the end.
Okay, strap in, everyone. You ready? When people talk about the Holocaust, they talk about the tragedy and horror of 6 million Jewish lives being lost to the Nazi war machine. But they never mention the thousands of gypsies that were killed by the Nazis. No one ever wants to talk about that because no one ever wants to talk about the positives.
I've never met Bill Cosby, so I'm not defending him. But let's just remember that he has a valuable legacy that I can't just throw away. I remember that he's the first black man to ever win an Emmy in television. I also remember that he's the first guy to make a cartoon with black characters where their lips and noses were drawn proportionally. And I remember that he partnered up with a clinical psychologist to make sure that there was not one negative image of African Americans on his show. Gave tens of millions of dollars to African American institutions of higher learning, and is directly responsible for thousands of black kids going to college, not just the ones he raped. I heard that when Martin Luther King stood on the steps of the Lincoln Memorial and said he had a dream, he was speaking into a PA system that Bill Cosby paid for. The point is this: he rapes, but he saves. And he saves more than he rapes, but he probably does rape.
I jerk off way too much, and it upsets me. I don't know why. Maybe it's because it's so selfish. I don't know what it is, but I know it's bad. There's something wrong with it. Like, I was thinking the other day that you can figure out how bad a person you are by how soon after September 11th you masturbated, like how long you waited. And for me, it was between the two buildings going down. So I have a feeling that I had to do it. I had to. Otherwise, they win. That's the way I was looking at it at the time. It was a strange time for all of us.
Earlier this week, I received the single greatest phone call of my life. And then just 5 minutes later, I got another call telling me that my dad is in the hospital. I said, yeah, I just heard. I mean, look, I don't want to give you guys the wrong impression, you know? I didn't hate my father. My father wasn't a bad guy. For instance, I never once, not ever, ever, saw my dad hit my mother. I mean, he was quick, and you can't... My sister just had a baby. My sister had a baby to try to save the relationship. But I still don't talk to her.
This might offend some of you. People say, smug, sanctimonious people, in my opinion, but people do say from time to time you hear them, Princess Diana should have been wearing a seatbelt. If she'd been wearing a seatbelt, she'd be here with us today. To those people, I say this. I say, you try snorting cocaine off a cock in the back of a limo while wearing a seatbelt. You can't be fucking done.
I'm not for abortion. Oh, shut up, nigga. I'm not for it, but I'm not against it either. It all depends on who I get pregnant. I don't care what your religious beliefs are or anything. If you have a dick, you need to shut the fuck up on this one. Seriously. The right to choose is their unequivocal right. Not only do I believe they have the right to choose, I believe that they shouldn't have to consult anybody. And ladies, to be fair to us, I also believe if you decide to have the baby, a man should not have to pay. That's fair. If you can kill this motherfucker, I can at least abandon him.
All right, when I was at school, a mate of mine got caught wanking in the showers. Nothing? Well, it ruined the school trip to Auschwitz.
Everybody has different words that offend them, different things that they hear that they get offended by. To me, the thing that offends me the most is every time that I hear the N-word. Not by the way, I mean the N-word. Literally, whenever a white lady on CNN with nice hair says the N-word, that's just white people getting away with saying that's all that is. They found a way to say N-word. It's bullshit, because when you say the N-word, you put the word in the listener's head. That's what saying a word is. You say the N-word and I go, oh, she means f***er. You're making me say it in my head. Why don't you fucking say it instead and take responsibility for the shitty words you want to say?
What was it like to take your friend to get her abortion? It was boring. I don't know why I thought it was going to be fun and exciting. But trust me. The only person more disappointed than me that day was the baby, right?
I watched the footage of Saddam being executed, and it really made me think. It made me think, is there nothing on the internet that I won't masturbate to?
Because child molesters are very tenacious people. They love molesting childs. It's crazy. It's like their favorite thing. I mean, it's so crazy, because when you consider the risk in being a child molester, speaking not of even the damage you're doing, but the risk, there is no worse life available to a human than being a caught child molester. And yet they still do it, which from you can only really surmise that it must be really good. I mean, from their point of view, not ours, but from their point of view, it must be amazing for them to risk so much. How do you think I feel? It's my last show, probably. Look, I can't key into it because I love Mounds bars. I love Mounds bars. It's my favorite thing, right? But there's a limit. I mean, I can't even eat a Mounds bar and do something else at the same time. That's how much I love them. Like, if I'm eating a Mounds bar, I can't read the paper. Like, I have to just sit there with it in my mouth and go, why is this so good? I love this so much. But And because they are delicious. And yet, if somebody said to me, if you eat another Mounds bar, you'll go to jail and everybody will hate you, I would stop eating them. Because they do taste delicious, but they don't taste as good as a young boy does and shouldn't. To a Chop Monster, not to me. Not to us, because we're all awesome. All right, we did it. We got it.
I would love to be gay. I'll tell you why, because I'm a man's man. I like men. Men like me. We like each other. I hate women. Women hate me. We hate each other. The only reason I couldn't be gay is because I could never fuck a man. Because I could never fuck something that I respect.
Now, my mom did her very best. Unfortunately, she was also a terrible person. Like my mom for most of her life, and this is true, my mom for most of her life was a Holocaust denier. Right? Does everybody know what that means? I mean, she couldn't believe the Holocaust happened. It's like the worst thing you can be. And it was terrible for the entire family to have to deal with. Until finally, a couple of years ago, we had an intervention. And we had a rabbi come into the home, had him walk her through the history of the Jewish people. And then he made her watch Schindler's List. And after that, my mom did a complete 180. Now, she can't believe it only happened once.
I think you know a girl is too young for you if you're having to make the aeroplane noise to get your cock in her mouth.
Here comes the train into the tunnel.